Jackson.
I'm Vanessa.
And I'm Quinn.
Welcome back to the Burg News.
In 5, 4, 3, 2.
Start a hybrid. This week we have some tips and tricks on how to stay safe and academically successful during this change.
Now for our daily announcements.
Coming up on November 7th, we have Picture Day. Sign up now for Sign Up Genius to come and pick a time slot and go and get your picture taken.
It's time to get spooky, Saxons, because tomorrow's Halloween. Whether you're staying inside or partying with your family, be sure to be safe and responsible.
That's all for your announcements. Next up, presenting our principal's monthly address with Mr. Harlan.
Greetings, Saxons. This is Mr. Harlan with the monthly principal's update. Last time I was on, I talked about the homecoming activities that were coming up. I want to start by thanking all of you that participated in the fun events we had, including the successful t-shirt pickup in our parking lot. Thank you to all of you who participated in a variety of ways. It was wonderful to see students back in the building this week with the start of the hybrid scenario. We hope that all of you that were in attendance enjoyed it as much as we did. I also want to thank you for paying close attention to the safety procedures put in place at SHS. As a reminder, if you selected the hybrid scenario, on days you are in person at SHS, you'll be receiving a link in your school email to take the daily health screener. Please remember to take this before coming to assure quick entry into the building on your in-person days. Coming up on Saturday, November 7th, our photography company will be on site taking updated student pictures. Please visit the SHS website to sign up for a time slot to get your updated picture taken. Seniors, you will take multiple pictures and have the opportunity to select one that will appear in the yearbook due to the difficulty you may have had scheduling your traditional senior portraits. As a reminder for all students, it is already the end of October. The end of the semester will be here before you know it. It is incredibly important to finish strong and stay engaged in your classes for the last 7 weeks of the semester, whether you're here in person or you're connecting remotely. Now's a great time to look through Schoology and Infinite Campus to assure you are caught up on all of your assignments. If you need help identifying what you need to turn in or prioritizing what you need to get done for a specific class, reach out to your teacher or counselor. They're here to help. All right, Saxons, thank you all very much. I hope you all had a wonderful start to November, and I look forward to connecting with all of you next time on the Burg.
Thank you, Mr. Harlan.
Everything is looking a lot different this year, including school. So now we have some tips and tricks on how to stay safe during hybrid regulations and processes.
Welcome back, students. We are so excited to have you back at Schaumburg High School starting on Monday for hybrid learning. What's different about hybrid? We'll review some changes that you should expect when returning to the building on Monday. The first step is that you will be emailed a daily wellness screening survey. Every day, you must complete this before traveling to school. So complete this on your iPad or your cell phone. When you complete it, you will either receive a green check mark, meaning you are eligible or allowed to come to the school building, or not eligible, and you must stay home and complete remote learning instead of hybrid learning. You will show this green check mark when you arrive to the school to student supervisors or administrators standing outside of the building. Face masks. You must have a face mask in order to enter the building as well. That mask must fit over your nose and mouth and fit snugly against the side of your face. Bandanas, neck gaiters, and masks with valves or vents are not allowed. It would be a great idea to bring an extra mask just in case your first one breaks. Let's hear from some students.
Hey Madeline, what did you do this weekend?
Hey Stephanie, you have to keep your mask over your nose and mouth.
Oh, okay.
Siggy says, make sure your mask covers your nose and mouth.
Siggy also says to stay 6 feet apart at all times to maintain social distancing. All of our building areas, including classrooms, are set up to ensure that students are social distancing at all times.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey, you're too close. You have to sit on a seat with no red dot. Make sure to always follow social distancing guidelines. Let's stay safe, Saxons.
As a reminder, the cafeteria will also have social distancing, so you're only able to sit on a chair that does not have a red dot to maintain your social distancing guidelines. How do you enter the building? There are going to be very specific directions to enter the building. When you arrive, an administrator or supervisor will direct you to either door 1 or door 2 to enter into the building, depending on the traffic flow of students. You will show your daily wellness screener from your iPad or cell phone first. Next, you'll scan in with your ID upon arrival into the corridor. You will walk through into the building and then go through the thermal temperature scanners to make sure that your temperature is 100.4 degrees or lower. And then you will walk directly to your first period class or to the cafeteria if you need breakfast. Here's a diagram of your first entrance, door 1. Again, you will show your survey here, enter in into the corridor to scan your IDs, and then you will enter in and turn right to go to the thermal scanner. It looks pretty similar when you look at entrance 2. Again, you have your green check mark here. You will enter in into the corridor, scan your IDs, to make sure you're eligible to enter, turn to the left at door 2 to do your thermal scanner, and circle around to go to your first period class. Here's an example to show you how that looks when you would arrive on Monday.
Hi, Schaumburg Saxons! Here is the video of how to enter the school building when you arrive for hybrid learning. First thing you will do when you come to school is you will show your green check mark to an administrator or supervisor. The next step, make sure that you have your student ID, because when you enter into the first set of doors, you will scan in to make sure that you are allowed in the building. Mr. McNider is going to demonstrate that for us.
Thank you.
So he gets a green light and gets to move on to the next step, which will be our temperature scanner. So we will continue into the building. You'll make a right and go through the temperature scanner. He will do a loop around and then we'll head to his first period class.
Just some information about your daily schedule. Passing periods will look a little different during hybrid learning. There are 3 5-minute passing periods between each class. Your teacher will assign a passing period to you. You may be in the first wave, the second wave, or the third wave. You must leave during your assigned passing period and arrive to your next class within that 5 minutes. During class, a teacher will assign you to a desk. This is so that you are always in the same spot for contact tracing purposes. You may receive a single-use pass for the restroom or pre-approved needs at the nurse's office. This may be, let's say you have medication that you have to take at a certain time in the nurse's office, or maybe you're diabetic and need to check your blood. Those are acceptable uses of those single-use pass for the nurse. Just so you're aware, restrooms have capacity limits, so make sure you're following the directions of the monitor. It may be a supervisor, it may be a teacher that's outside of each restroom to ensure you're following social distancing guidelines. When you're in the hallway, things will look a little different as well. We will have two-way traffic, one-way traffic, two-way staircases, and one-way staircases. So make sure you're looking at the signs in each hallway and each staircase to make sure that you are going the correct way. We have this labeled throughout the building on our ground floor, our first floor, and our second floor. As a reminder, all hallways and stairwells have been marked with signs so that you know which direction and what side you should walk. When you're in the hallways, make sure you're moving with a purpose. We want to prevent overloading different parts of the building and ensure that everyone is keeping their 6 feet distance. Make sure you wash your hands and use hand sanitizer as necessary when you're moving through the hallways and especially after bathroom use. Let's hear again from some students. When you're in the classroom, we want to make sure that we are cleaning and sanitizing to make sure that everyone is staying safe. Teachers will spray the desk or chair once you leave for your passing period. The sanitizing spray dries within 3 minutes, but if by chance you return to your class and it is not dry, there are paper towels that you can use to dry it by the time you arrive. Sanitizer for your hands is available in every classroom. If you're in a lab class, such as culinary, science, different labs within the applied tech area, you can find gloves in your classroom to make sure that you are not touching high touch areas after other students. And just so you're aware, no food is allowed in the classroom, but you may drink water. Here's our principal demonstrating how you would drink water in the classroom while wearing a mask.
Here's your principal, Mr. Harlan, who's going to demonstrate how to drink from a bottle of water in your classroom.
Thanks, Mr. Harlan. As a reminder for sophomores, juniors, and seniors, this might be very new information for our freshmen. We have very specific cell phone procedures at Schaumburg High School. When you cross into your classroom, cell phones should not be used and should not be visible once you are in that classroom. So you are in the hallway, put that in your pocket before you enter the classroom. If you're not following procedures, it can result in some consequences. Your first and second violation will be a warning email that are sent to the parent and to you, the student. A third or fourth violation, an email is sent, an administrator will come to your classroom and confiscate your phone for the day. Because of safety procedures, we will be having you place the cell phone into a Ziploc bag. We will then take the cell phone down to the intervention office and lock it up in a cell phone locker. You, as a student, would pick it up at the end of the day. Let's hope not, but if you get to a fifth or sixth violation, an email again is sent to the parent and guardian, and you, the student. An administrator will again confiscate that phone, but the parent or guardian will have to come pick up your cell phone from school, and we will have a meeting to discuss your cell phone usage. Any more violations, we'll have to talk about extended loss of privileges at school. If you are requesting an appointment, because of passes are being restricted to just the bathroom and the nurse's office, if you want to see your administrator, the dean of students, or school resource officer, on your iPad, you will have an app that you can request an appointment for the intervention office. On that app, you'll indicate what the meeting you're requesting is about and how quickly you need to see that administrator or the dean or the school resource officer. If you're looking to see student services, so a counselor, a psychologist, or a social worker, you'll use the Sign Up Genius or email your counselor to request an appointment. That's it for now. We are so excited to see you, Saxons. Have a great weekend and stay safe.
Thanks, guys.
We know it's a lot, Saxons. So to help you out, we have Linnea and Josh letting you know ways to stay on top of school during hybrid.
Trying to keep track of your assignments can be confusing when you have classes every other day. To make sure you remember when something is due, keep a planner or even use a notebook to write down your assignments. If you don't need your phone for Zoom, put it somewhere where you won't be tempted to use it. It's a good idea to place it somewhere that you would have to walk in order to get it, so you can't easily reach over and get distracted. Being in your pajamas makes you feel too comfortable so that you'll most likely fall asleep. To try to put on something you know will make you feel tired, but comfortable enough. Even though you can wake up later than you normally would to go to school, it is still important to get a full night's sleep. Go to bed at a decent time so that you're not struggling to wake up and stay awake the next day. Stay organized. Where you study has a huge impact on how you study. When in a clean area, you know where everything is and you stay consistent with work. Lastly, to keep your energy up, eat a good breakfast so that you feel energized and ready for the day.
Thanks, Josh and Linnea. Now it's over to Quinn for sports.
Starting with golf, Emily Akers was a fourth place medalist at the IHSA Regional Golf Tournament. In cross country, Ashley Jenks placed 17th place all conference at the MSL Girls Cross Country Conferences Meet.
Lately, at the MSL Swimming Conference Meet,
Maddie Born broke the conference pool record for the 100-meter backstroke, and Nina Mellon broke multiple records, including the conference record and the pool record.
For 100,
I am.
The pool
and school record for 100 meters breaststroke,
and all three records for the 100-meter fly.
What a great fall sports season, Saxons. Well, that's all for this week, Saxons.
Thanks for watching. See you next time on the Burg.
And happy Halloween.